Hey guys, and welcome back. Today I'm going to be sharing with you everything you need to know about the new Soap & Glory face masks. So these are called the Mask Force Beauty Must Haves. And with that being said, let's move right into the demos and explaining a little bit about each of them. So first up we have the Miracle Moisture Mask. Now this is a gel mask that comes in two parts, and the mask is infused with hyaluronic acid and Soap & Glory's Pink Flower Power. This claims to help smooth and hydrate the skin, and it's especially good for dry or dehydrated skin. Initially, when I pulled this out, I noticed how well saturated this was. It's also a little weighty compared to a tissue mask. So to start with, I found this a bit fiddly to apply and the bottom part did slide off initially. However, this is a great pick-me-up mask that's both refreshing and smells gorgeous. And afterwards, my skin felt super soft, smooth and hydrated. Next is the Pore Refining Mask. This is a tissue skin smoothing mask which helps to refine pores and absorb excess oils. It also contains chamomile and mint fragrance to help both refresh and cool the skin. Again, this was well saturated and you could definitely smell the mint and also eucalyptus. And overall, this felt super cooling on the skin, and afterwards it made my skin feel and look so much more refreshed, and I also felt my skin look more refined too. Next, onto the Radiance Boosting Mask, which is infused with a number of brightening ingredients to help bring your skin back to life. This is especially targeted as a party recovery mask for dull and lackluster skin. Upon application, my skin felt immediately refreshed, and towards the end, I felt a slight cooling sensation too. After, my skin felt lovely and revived, and you can also take any excess serum and rub it down onto the neck. The last mask is the Declog Mask, which is for, as Soap & Glory put it, lifting out gunk and junk. This peel-off mask has two pods for two uses, as well as a spatula to apply the mask. Be warned, this is a little messy to apply, and it's recommended you focus this mostly on the T-zone or any specific problem areas. I ended up applying this to the whole face, as you do get a generous amount in one capsule. Now this is eye-watering to pull off and it is a little drying afterwards, but this definitely did the trick at reducing my blemishes and spots. Lastly, we have the Puffy Eye Attack, which claims to refresh and revitalize tired, puffy eyes. Now these are nice and thick and have a slight scent to them, and on the eyes they felt cooling. However, I think these would be even more refreshing if you put them in the fridge. Afterwards, my eyes definitely felt and looked more brighter.
So guys, thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did find it helpful. And also, definitely let me know which one you like the look of in the comments down below. Also, don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram, Pinterest, Twitter and Snapchat for more inspiration. And if you missed my last video, you can go ahead and click on the picture link in the middle and that will take you to that video. Have a wonderful start to the week, guys, and I'll look forward to seeing you in my next one. Take care, bye.